Medical schools across the UK interview their candidates before offers are given out. A lot of the time, interviewers are looking for things like communication skills, integrity, teamwork, and suitability to the MBBS course.
It can be a really daunting time in the medical school entry process, so congratulations to those that have an interview lined up. And if you're still waiting to hear back, try not to worry too much.
Medical school interviews at Newcastle University involve an MMI format. This stands for multiple mini interview. What this entails is you'd have lots of little interview stations, each lasting for about 7 minutes. One of them will be a role-playing station, but you won't be tested on any actual medical knowledge.
Kind of like speed dating, in that you rotate around stations with different interviewers, where they ask different questions and assess sort of individually different components. And so I think this is quite a good way of doing it. It means you can start afresh with each station, which is always good.
Before my medical school interview, I made sure to do my research. I made sure to find out what style of interview I would be having at Newcastle University. Like I said before, it usually is MMI, but other universities might do panel interview, so make sure you double check the format.
Because I was classed as an international student, I did what was called a panel interview, and that basically involved me having a discussion with two members from the Faculty of Medical Sciences and just answering some of the questions that they had.
Dress appropriately for your medicine interview. Make sure you're wearing something that you would feel comfortable having a job interview in.
A few weeks leading up to my interviews, I started spending some time online on student forums and sort of just watching videos of past student experiences to get an idea of what type of things I could expect to be asked during my interview. I use a lot of different online resources, and some really good ones that I recommend include MedicMind and Medic Portal.
I found practice questions on websites like the Medic Portal, which have individual sections for each UK university, and the interview questions that usually come up. It's important not to over-prepare the questions. You don't want it to sound rehearsed like a script. The interviewers are looking for you to be natural and to speak what you think.
Sometimes I would rehearse my answers in front of the mirror just to feel confident and sort of comfortable answering the questions.
I also then got my mum to ask me questions every night, and it didn't matter what the question was, even if it was really hard and I didn't have an answer, it was good to be put in that position, so you're just sort of preparing yourself mentally for that feeling of, oh, I'm not sure what I'm going to say next.
Another top tip I have is to make sure you research some ethical information. Places like the Medical Schools Council webpage or the General Medical Council's webpage can give information into things like the ethical pillars of medicine, which you can apply to ethical scenarios at interview.
I was actually really pleasantly surprised because it was a really comfortable environment, and both of those members of staff did a really good job at making it feel more like a conversation rather than an interview.
At Newcastle, they tend to provide a sort of structure or template or a bit of guidance on what kinds of questions you can be asked, and they typically tend to be things like why this university, why this medical school, why medicine in general, how have you demonstrated teamwork, leadership, communication skills.
During my interview, I was asked quite a lot of questions about why Newcastle University specifically. I made sure to have knowledge of the city and the university and what happened on Newcastle University's MBBS course. You want to show the interviewer that you're not only like the university, but also the city as well.
The other thing that I spoke about is the fact that in your clinical years, you can be placed in different base units. So for example, right now, I spend a lot of my time being placed in Durham. And in my interview, I spoke a little bit about the fact that being placed in these different areas would expose me to sort of a wide patient demographic, and I would find this quite helpful for my clinical learning.
Make sure that you're also looking at any possible medical stories in the news that are happening at the time of your interview. It means that you can apply this to any questions that they give you.
The other thing I was asked is what I sort of learned and gained from my work experience that I had done, regardless of whether that was sort of hospital-based or in the community.
And when you're talking through these examples, make sure you've got another one in the back of your mind, just in case the interviewer says, oh, can you give me another example as well?
I would be lying if I said I wasn't the slightest bit anxious before my interview, and it's important to remember that those feelings are completely normal and valid. So feeling anxious, worried, or stressed, that's completely normal. Going into your interview sort of very calm, relaxed, and confident is so important because it sort of sets up the stage for you to be able to show off your abilities and what you have to offer to the university.
What I would say is to remind yourself that everyone's in the same boat, everyone feels the exact same, and you can only try your best.
It's perfectly fine to say, oh, can I just take a couple of seconds? I'm just going to think through things. And I think as well, if you feel like you've given a bit of a poor response, saying, oh, can I do that again? I don't think that was my best. Am I okay to give that another go? They want you to perform at your best. You know, they're on your side. So just try and take your time and think through things. So how did I feel after the interview? Well, for the most part, relieved, I think, to have another one down. I think it's very easy to fixate on the tiny little things that didn't quite go to plan and forget that on the whole you performed really well. So just try and keep that in mind, particularly when you're waiting to hear if you've got an offer.
One of my biggest tips would be to try not to predict the outcome of the interview, just because it can take quite a while for you to get your results back. So for me, it took a few weeks to find out if I was successful or not. That time period can be quite worrying, just because different universities will tell their outcomes at different points, and if you've done an interview at the same time as a friend, they might find out a little bit sooner, a little bit later.
Best of luck for your medical school interviews at Newcastle University. Hopefully see you at the university soon.